It's a pretty even character. What do you do against the Rob v. Rob Mirror matchup? I'll tell you what you do. You go in with the projectiles, you go in with the Nair, you go in with the Fair, and you get him up to 60%. Hydra, this is gonna get pretty dangerous. Now, here's what I'm seeing a lot from J-Swiss. He's able to get in quite easily on Hydra, but Hydra retaliates so much that he just gets damage for free. I don't know how much longer I can ramble. Ooh, baby. But yeah, Hydra trying to go for the American Sniper. Chris Kyle play, unfortunately gonna whiff and get him up to 122%.
Yeah, right now, J-Swiss just trying to keep Hydra in this disadvantage state of being near the ledge, but it's not going to work out for him. Hydra turns it around super quick, and in a flash, if you will, loses a stock, takes away a stock, I should say.
Absolutely. I mean, this game's pretty interesting, because we've seen a lot of back and forth between J-Swiss and Hydra's Rob. They have a relatively similar play style, and I mean, how can you not? It's Rob. That's not going to kill.
Oh, hey. Pretty good sniper, the gyro. Oh, he had one of his own. He had it in his back pocket. Completely throws J-Swiss off of his balance.
You're not the only one who has the power of toys at his disposal. Hydra coming in with those anime comebacks, getting J-Swiss up to 78%. Hydra at 183. Is he dead? Yes.
Yo, dude, Andy from Toy Story from Smash.
He would be so overpowered. Like, I'm imagining him as, like, a puppeteer character where he controls all the toys in a similar manner to, like imagine Zelda Down Special, but it's every move, and they each have combo ability.
Andy's too strong. Andy's the next Bayonetta, man.
Andy's the next Bayonetta. Dante's the next Bayonetta. We have a lot of Bayonetta character suggestions.
We'll see what happens when Joker comes out, man.
Mm-hmm. And Monster Hunter. I'm positive that Monster Hunter's coming out. Like, there's no way they will not be out on Smash Ultimate.
I can see that.
I will bet $10,000 go into crippling debt, ooh, much like J-Swiss taking that L. Hydra coming out with a win.
J-Swiss, really good Rob. We didn't really talk about a whole lot. A really good Rob, also from Illinois. It doesn't really come down here all that much, but Hydra is able to stomp on him that time around. Able to take game one of this set.
Yeah, absolutely. Hydra's trying to teach J-Swiss, you don't just come down here to my territory. There can only be one Rob in this Illinois section, and let me tell you, I'm gonna be the one.
Can there only be one Rob, though? I mean, they're like mass-produced.
They are mass-produced, you're not wrong. I mean,
technically anyone could be Rob.
Yeah, you're really not wrong. He is a toy at the end of the day.
Yeah.
And Hydra's getting toyed around with quite a bit by J-Swiss, getting up to 51% just off of two combos.
I tell you, if you weren't gonna make that transition, I was, because that was on deck. The toying around.
It's too good not to make. I feel like I would have failed as a commentator if I didn't take that advantage.
Trying to hit that back air, take away J-Swiss's stock as fast as possible. For the most part, this game is pretty even so far. And something I really wasn't able to mention, I got a little sidetracked, but Rob has a very interesting gameplay style of being someone who has, like, projectile options, but seemingly does best as, like, a rush-down character.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, it's interesting how Rob has so much zoning potential, right? With his neutral B, his side, or sorry, no, is that down?
Speaking
down
of side B.
Yeah, side, side there's B. Side B. Down B with the gyro.
Yeah.
Like, he has a lot of options as far as zoning goes, but he's also able to get in, rack up damage, and get some really solid kill confirms, especially off of that side B, which I mistook for gyro. Sorry, y'all.
Gave both of them a headache right there. That gyro hit each other at the same time. But,
I was waiting for him to pause the game, both turn their heads around looking at us like, are you serious? Are you kidding? Get off that chair.
That was timed perfectly well, too.
Yeah, absolutely.
Hell no, dude, you have like 18
happened?
Jumps. What happened? You have the most jumps.
See, did you use
you can fly.
I don't understand. What happened there?
I have no idea.
Homie stock? Homie stock?
It was a really late homie stock.
Homie stock in winner's quarters?
Yeah,
like,
there we go. I mean, hey, if there was one at Evo Grands, I mean, you could have one anywhere.
You're not wrong. I don't think anyone's ever going to forget the homie stocks there. But I'll tell you what I'm not going to forget about. Hydra getting these kill confirms.
Dude.
And the tech from J-Swiss.
Dude, that a lifesaver if I've ever seen one in my entire career. Yeah, oh my goodness.
Good God. Hydra's Rob is absolutely insane. I feel like he's just so easy to adapt with. And Jace Wiss is unfortunately not able to keep up as much, getting up to 138% and in a dangerous spot.
You know what's kind of funny? Whenever two Rob gyros hit each other at the same time, they're basically just playing Beyblades.
Oh.
They're basically, that's all they're doing. I can't believe that Fair killed. Fair is one of those moves from Rob that looks like so weak. It's kind of like Love Tap. It looks like Rob just like sort of like, it looks like he coughs. Like it looks like he's bending over to cough and it just and knocks him out. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. I'll tell you, they're getting a lot of Chris Kyle American Sniper lasers out here. Both of them getting shielded, but Jace Wiz is not having any of it. Getting Hydra off the top blast zone. It's an even game, folks.
That was nice. Trying to utilize that gyro to keep Jace Wiz in a bad position off stage. Jace Wiz not letting it interrupt his style, though, getting back into neutral. And once again, this game is very even at the moment.
Yeah, absolutely. I like what Jace Wiz did earlier. While it might have looked like he just kept going for up air, spamming that, it is such a good option for Rob. It's one of his best anti-airs, and I'm glad he kept going for it because it's forced Hydra to walk back a little bit and take a little bit of damage, but it looks like they're relatively even now.
Yeah, it's pretty much been that way since they both had one stock left. Blow for blow, projectile for projectile. Neither one is giving an inch. Anyone's game for sure. Watch out for that up air, my man.
Absolutely. Jace Wiz recovering higher than the Sears Tower. Thank you, Chicago residents. And,
hey, you mean the Willis Tower.
Shut up. It's never not going to be the Sears Tower, much like how it's never not going to be Hydra's game that time. Coming in with the down throw to up air special, Hydra takes this set.
Yeah, anytime there's not a cinematic finish, I feel like I was lied to.
Yeah.
Like, I don't even, like, think.